Hi guys, and welcome to this Scrape Ops tutorial. In this video, we're going to look at how to log in using Python Scrapy. So as part of that, we're going to be looking at first the basics of logging in, what actually happens behind the scenes. Then we're going to go through and log into a basic server-side rendered login form. And then we're going to go into a bit more complicated stuff where we're going to look at how to actually log in using a headless browser to a page that's been client-side rendered. So that's just the overview. Let's jump in now into the basics of logging in. So the first page we're going to look at scraping is this quotes to scrape login form. So this is a very standard login form with just a username and password. You know, usually it's either username and password or email and password, and then a login button. So if we actually inspect the page, we can have a look at and see what the form consists of. So we can see that it's a form with a post method. So it's going to be posting the data. Once the submit button is clicked, it has a hidden field with a CSRF token. So this token is used to make sure that we are the person who is actually doing the logging in. This token is usually tied to our session, and it makes it much harder for hackers to pretend to be us, basically. So this is the important ingredient here, which we're going to be focusing on in this first part of the tutorial. And then obviously the next two parts are just the username input field and the password input field. So for this tutorial, we don't need to actually put in anything specific. Anything will work here. And if we actually click login, it then brings us to the rest of the quotes to scrape site. So what we can do then is just go through and scrape the quotes like we would normally. So the main thing is insert data into the username field, insert data into the password field, make sure we've copied the CSRF token, and then post all that data over to the server side. So we're actually going to look at how we can code that up now. So for this tutorial, we're going to use the basic Scrapy project that we have available for anyone to download. So I'll have this linked in the description of the video below. So first things first, we're just going to clone this project locally. So I already have a folder created, and in this folder, I'm going to just git clone the project. Okay, now that it's cloned, I can set up the Python virtual environment. Again, all these steps are listed in under the basic Scrapy project. I'm going to activate the environment. I'm going to install Scrapy, and then we should be able to check if everything is installed correctly by just running Scrapy list. So first thing, we just need to go into our project and then run Scrapy list, and we can see that there is a spider called quotes there. So now that the basic Scrapy project is up and running, we can actually go in and create a new spider. So we have our quote spider here. Let's go ahead, copy that, and just paste it in. And we'll rename it, and we'll call it basic login spider. As part of this tutorial, I'm going to be following along a guide that we've written out. And this guide will also be available in the description. So we have the full guide of everything we're going to be talking about here in this video, along with code snippets and more in-depth pieces of code, which you can examine at your leisure. So let's go back to our spider. We're going to just create a basic spider called basic login spider. As you can see, the name is set there, and we're going to be scraping the quotes to scrape site that we just looked at. The first thing it's going to do is it's going to request this URL, and then once that page is actually returned, it's going to go to the login function. This login function is then going to look for the CSERF token, and it's going to do that by looking at the CSS selector for the form input, where the name is CSRF underscore token, and it's going to extract that out and put it into the token variable. And then once we have the token, we can go ahead and create a form request. So we're importing Scrapy HTTP form request up at the top. And in this form request, we're going to put in the CSERF token, which we need, or else it won't let us log in. The password, which can be anything, we've put in foobar. The username, which can be anything, we've put in foobar. And then the callback is to another function called start scraping. So then we'll just add that function in now. That function called start scraping just takes the response and, using the CSS selector, looks at all the quotes that are on the page and then returns those quotes by extracting out the text, the author, and the tag from each one of these. So it's quite simple. We go to login page, get the token, and then send the details of the form to the form login URL, and then we start scraping the page once we're logged in. So let's go ahead now and see, can we log in using that? So as you can see, we've the two spiders are available now. The next thing we want to do is just do Scrapy crawl basic login spider. If we scroll up, we can see that we crawled the login page, and then we can see that there was a post request, and then we can see that the different quotes are being outputted to the terminal. So that's worked correctly. So for most server-side rendered pages, it's as simple as using something basic like this. There's no need to over-engineer anything. It's usually just the CSERF token, the email, and the password. And it's simple as that. So now let's look at a bit more complicated scenario. So for that, we're going to be looking at how we can scrape Amazon. I'm sure most of you are familiar with the Amazon login. So they have it split into two parts. The first part is you enter your email or mobile phone number, click continue, and then the second part is they ask you for the password, and then you finish the sign-in. So the reason we have to do some client-side rendering here is that when this happens, they expect certain amounts of JavaScript to be actually run in your browser. So without a browser, you won't be able to actually complete the login process. So to use the client-side rendering side of things, we're going to be using Scrapy Splash. So I already have that installed. As you can see, it's running here in a Docker container, and it's running on port 8050 for me locally on my machine. So we have a separate tutorial for that, which will be linked also in the description, and we go through how to render and scrape JavaScript rendered sites with Scrapy Splash. Okay, now that we've got Scrapy Splash up and running, the next thing we're going to do is we're going to go back to our spider and we're going to update our settings so that we have everything we need to run Scrapy Splash correctly. So I'm just going to paste in a bunch of settings here and I'll go through them. So the first thing we want to do is robots.txt obey is going to be false, because obviously Amazon is not going to be wanting us to log in using a scripted solution. Next, we're going to have our user agent set here, which is important so that we're not sending the user agent Scrapy. We have our splash URL here, which is just the Scrapy splash endpoint. We have the downloader middlewares and the spider middlewares, again, everything to do with Scrapy splash, and just a duplicate filter class as well. So now that we have that, let's go ahead and once again add a new spider. So we'll just copy our existing one, paste it in, and we're going to call this one Headless Browser Login Spider. So just so we know the difference. Browser Login Spider, perfect. And let's just delete everything we have in here. The first thing we're going to do is just add in the basics, which are going to be the imports at the top. And we're going to create the main class, Headless Browser Login Spider. We're going to name our spider Amazon Login. We're going to have our start requests function, which is the first function that runs when you run a spider. So this contains a sign-in URL. Then we're doing a splash request, and we're going to say, go to this URL, and then execute a script, which is, we'll just import now, our Lua script. So this Lua script is going to sit above the class. We're going to initialize the cookies, go to the URL, wait for the page to load, get the email input, set the text of the email input to my email address. Then it's going to submit the form. It's going to click on the email submit button. It's going to wait 3 seconds. Then it's going to find the password input and then submit the password. And it's going to wait 3 seconds. So at the end of that 3 seconds, Scrapy Splash is going to get a PNG render of the page. It's going to get the HTML of the page, and it's going to get the cookies that were collected from the page. So that's what the script is doing. Then once that is finished executing, the next thing that happens is it goes to this callback. So we need to add in our start scraping function for that to work correctly. So in our start scraping function, the first thing that's going to happen is that it's going to create a screenshot called afterlogin.png, and it's going to write that out into the spider folder. So that's just so we can be sure that we are actually logged in. That's a very useful thing we have with Scrapy Splash. And then once it's done the screenshot, the next part here is it gets all the cookies and creates a Python dictionary, and then we're going to use those cookies when we just use the normal Scrapy request function. Just to let you guys know here that these cookies that are being passed into the Scrapy request is what makes Amazon know that we're logged in. So if these cookies are not passed in, Amazon will not know that you have already filled out the login form. Even if you have just before that done it, it needs these cookies to be passed in to the Scrapy request because that's where your session cookies are set. So within this dictionary, there's a whole pile of cookies that you can print out if you want and have a look at what they are. We go into more detail in the article, but there's all these different cookies, and that's what Amazon uses to remember that you're logged in. So they need to be passed in to every Scrapy request from now on. So we have the cookies, we have our URL. Normally here, you might have a massive list of Amazon URLs that you want to scrape while being logged in. So that's why we have it as a list here. But we're just going to add in, for the purpose of this tutorial, just the one URL. So what's going to happen then is it's going to do a Scrapy request, which is just your standard Python Scrapy request. It's not a splash request, as you can see here. It's there are different request types. And then once that request comes back, it's going to hit this parse function. So let's just add that parse function in now. So that parse function will then save the response that comes back, basically all the HTML, and it'll save that as response.html. And then once it does that, the next part of it is it looks for all the URLs that are on the page, again using our CSS selector. And it loops through all these URLs that are on the page, and it extracts the URL text, if there is a text that goes along with the URL, and the URL itself. And it prints out an error if it's unable to do that correctly. So I've got that wrapped in a try except there, just to do a bit of error checking. So the only other thing that's left to do is just to install Scrapy Splash in our virtual environment. So let's just do a pip install Scrapy Splash. Let's do a Scrapy list once more. Oh, we might need to just deactivate the environment and reactivate the environment just to make sure that we get the latest stuff. Just go back up, reactivate it, go back into our folder, and now if we run Scrapy list, we have everything working. So before we run it again, there's just one last thing I almost forgot to do, and that is to obviously put in the login details that we're going to be using. So for this, I'm just using this account I created today, and you have to put in your own details here, obviously. But now that those details are in, let's run Scrapy crawl as on login. The screenshot should be taken and the main page after being logged in should be created. So we see the after login PNG file was created, and as you can see up the top, it has hello at scrapeops up the top, so it is logged in. And if we check the response HTML, and it says not joe at scrapeops.io, and it says hello joe at scrapeops.io, so that did log in correctly. Then if we scroll up here, we can see all the URL text and the URLs that were scraped from the page. There you have it. We successfully logged into Amazon and then scraped all the URLs from the main homepage after being logged in. So all the code that we used will be in a separate repo as well in the description, which you can download and just run. So you don't have to copy and paste each bit like we did today. So you'll have the beginner project that you can follow along with, and you'll have the fully complete project that you can just run. So it's up to you. And if you guys have any other questions or comments, or you're stuck on any part of this video, just let us know in the comments below, and we'll do your very best to help you out. So see you in the next video, guys, and thanks for watching.